highway bridge in Hamilton. To the left there is last year a dump truck trailer, I guess you can call it. It wasn't a dump truck, but it was a dumper trailer semi-truck. He had his box a little up and went right into that bridge, causing a lot of headaches. But there's water on both sides of us here. Actually looks pretty good, but today's kind of a gloomy day, so not too spectacular. Oh, we got a sailboat out there to the left. The wind's good for it, that's for sure. But yeah, there's a lot of steel mills and pits in Hamilton here. I think they got a couple paper mills. Maybe one. Just telling me my fuel is low, that's what that beep was. We're gonna take care of that when we hit the J there in Fort Erie. We should have enough fuel for that. Exit 5, I believe. And what are we coming up to? 92. Yeah, it's a little less than an hour. We should be good. It's kilometers because we're in Canada. This is just before the Fort Erie Buffalo border, Peace Bridge. Gonna go in there to a Flying J here, and we're gonna fuel. Also gotta get some DEF, and I don't think I'm gonna fill the tanks. I think I'm just gonna top up. I think it's pretty expensive. I could be wrong, but I think it's over a buck again. Like probably a buck five a liter. Still don't have the entry number. Still waiting for that. I do, I know Customs has accepted it. My load here and my paperwork. I just don't have my entry numbers yet, and I'm 5 kilometers from the border, so we'll have to figure that one out. I really don't want to be waiting too long because it just eats up time, and I have to stop at the border anyway, going to duty free to get currency exchange. So I think today might just be a full day of delays. Once we get over the border, though, I mean, it's pretty smooth sailing. So did a good job with all this stuff. I don't know why they would make this lane end right where vehicles are going to be turning. That's kind of crazy. I would have cut all this back on the right here and made another lane go right through. A lot of trucks are going to be turning here for the J. It's all new. For the longest time, you had to come in the back way, because this was all torn up and blocked off. And here's the Flying J Travel Plaza. 105.9 for diesel. That's per liter. So, roughly about $4 a gallon. So we fueled up here. We filled up our DEF as well. I got back to the truck. Got my ACE message sent to me. So now all I got to do is just send a request for them to fax it to here. So I do that through the computer. And then we're going to get going down to the border. So we're coming up to the exit here for the Peace Bridge. And we're going to stop at duty free first. Got to do some currency exchange. And this duty free has Timmy's in it, a Tim Hortons, so it's going to be the last Timmy's for a bit, so I might as well grab one there. It's always nice to cross and get your last one when you can. Basically ready to cross, just gotta do the pit stop. Pretty nice duty free. Really clean in there. Clean bathrooms. Not like Detroit. That's just nasty. Spot right here. I'm a little crooked. Not a big deal. Only going to be a minute. Holy hell. Exchange rate is brutal right now. I just exchanged 160 Canadian and I got 116 back. That's right. 116. It's something like 1.356 right now is the exchange rate. That is just crazy. That something's got to happen, because otherwise I'm going to stop going US. Anyway, we are going to get ready to cross the Peace Bridge here. So we're on the I-90, which in New York here, it's a toll road west of Buffalo. We've just come out of Buffalo, so I'm gonna go through these toll booths. It's pretty good. I know they're doing some work last time I was coming through here. Kind of held us up. I don't know. I'm figuring it should be close to done by now. It's been quite some time since I've come through here. Oh, look at those race cars over there. It's like Cascar or something. Not NASCAR. I think the one lane for easy pass is 20. Yeah, here's the 20 mile an hour one. If you take the left one, it's only 5 mile an hour. Good to go. So now we're paying to use this part of the highway. It'll be a toll road all the way to Pennsylvania. We're gonna get into Pennsylvania and take the 79 South. That's what we're going to be doing. And we'll take that to like 77. We're going to go through Buckley and all that stuff. There's a nice US highway that I used to jot across, which is nice. But we'll be here for a while. It'll be about an hour, hour and a half, I think. And then we'll be in PA, Pennsylvania. Now here we got some high winds and pretty heavy rain. Could be worse, could be the white stuff. But, yeah. Just kind of came out of the blue. It was starting to get dark and then all of a sudden, boom. Just saw a wall of rain. You could see right where you're going to hit the rain. It's not like it gradually came in. But it doesn't look like we'll be in it very long. Clouds look a little broken up ahead. Some light coming through. None of them look threatening. Behind us, though, is black, black, dark as hell. In the trees, look at the trees, how they're moving there. It's usually a good indication. Most truck drivers are looking at the tips of the trees to find out if it's, you know, the wind that's pushing you around, the uneven pavement, grooves in the in the highway, or maybe you're just getting tired and you need to get off the road. That's another possibility, but yeah, the trees tell you a lot for wind when they're moving like that. And we're light, we're only about 13,000 pounds, so practically empty. Pushing this trailer around pretty good. I don't even know if you can hear me over the wind, or even if you can hear the wind. So, first time GoPro for the truck during the day, so who knows what's gonna happen. This might not even make the reel, you know. I'll figure it out when I go to edit. Yeah, certain, the rain's calming down, but the wind sure isn't. Really got to steer into it just to try to keep her straight. Man, those got to be about 50 mile per hour gusts. It's got to be constantly getting hit with a, I don't know, maybe about a 25-35 mile an hour crosswind here. But get hit with the gusts when you get out into the open, as soon as the tree line opens up. And bridges are the worst. As soon as you pop out on the other side, you usually get hit with a nice crosswind. And you ever see a truck do that and it just happened after a bridge, or you just get into a clearing and it's windy out, you probably got hit pretty hard. It's not him not being able to control his truck, just it catches us off guard. You don't want to jerk the steering wheel too quick, too much. No, that's not good either. So, but yeah, these crosswinds, yeah, wow, they're probably around 55, 65 miles an hour when you get that gust. Damn. Well, about another hour or so, we'll be heading south. So, if you're going with it, if it's still windy, it'll be a nice tailwind. That'll help for fuel economy. Our luck, it'll turn around and be a headwind. So here I am at Portersville, Pennsylvania. I am stopped at a Pilot. Didn't go as far as I want, as normal, but this rain kind of got to me, and I was up since 5 this morning, and it's, what is it now, it's 6:30? Yeah, 6:30, so what can you do? I still got a couple days to get there, 1,200 miles, bottom side of Florida, kind of west of Miami, I believe. So, yeah, I'm just basically going to grab a bite to eat and do some editing, and I'm going to bed. I'm going to try to get an early start, but we'll see how that goes. So, well, remember to like, subscribe, and share.